यस, गुड इवनिंग।
गुड इवनिंग मैम। गुड इवनिंग मैम। गुड
गुड
इवनिंग मैम।
इवनिंग।
गुड इवनिंग मैम। गुड इवनिंग मैम।
आई एम एक्सपेक्टिंग फ्रॉम समबडी एल्स। गुड इवनिंग।
गुड इवनिंग मैम।
वन मोर। अमल, गुड इवनिंग।
गुड इवनिंग मैम।
यस, हू आर एब्सेंट टुडे? महक एंड अमल। ओके, यू ऑल सीम टू बी इन सम फॉर्म ऑफ कलर कोड। इवन आई एम इन वाइट टुडे, ब्लैक एंड वाइट, सो मेनी ब्लैक वाइट्स एंड पिंक। ओके फाइन, so what was the chapter's name? Read the whole textbook but forgot to look at the title. What is the chapter's name?
Variation in psychological attributes.
Variation in la 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 la.
Variation in psychological attributes.
Variation in psychological attributes. Okay. And did you understand anything from last day's class? Yes? No? Grishma has learned Amal Raj's yes and no, I think. Yes? No? Sana, did you understand anything from last day's class? Yes. What did you understand? Come on. What is our chapter about? What is the theme of the chapter? Who can tell me?
Attributes,
psychological attributes. Okay, and what is the main concept that we discussed in last class?
Individual difference.
Individual differences and
situationism.
Individual differences and situations. Okay, and I told you to read about the domains. Did you read? Domains of psychological attributes. Amal, did you read? Yes. From next day onwards, you have to study all the portions from the previous class. If you don't answer my questions, then imposition. Mandatory imposition. What did you say, Ashish? Just a minute. Yes. So, what else did we discuss? Why did we discuss about the domains of psychological attributes? Under which topic?
Assessments.
Assessment. Okay. And what is assessment? Or what do you do in assessment?
It is a measurement of different psychological attributes.
Yeah. Do we only measure it or we do something else with that?
Evaluation.
Yes. We measure that and we evaluate it based on certain comparison standards using different methods. Okay. So, going back, what do you mean by individual differences? Definition. Individual differences.
The differences in behavior patterns in each individual.
Behavior patterns and something else.
Characteristics.
Characteristics, yes. Okay, learn that definition. 1 minute. I'll give you 1 minute. Learn that fast. I'll read the definition once more. Individual differences refer to distinctiveness and variations. Note that distinctiveness and variations among peoples, two things, characteristics and behavior patterns. Okay, so when you ask the definition of difference, you can write the word difference in the definition again. Okay, so you have to change that slightly. Either you write distinctiveness plus variations among people's characteristics. They are two things, characteristics and behavior patterns. That is known as individual differences. Individual differences refers to distinctiveness and variations among people's characteristics and behavior patterns. Okay, learn that fast. Understand it and learn. If you understand it and learn, if you elaborate, if you do deep level processing, it will enter which memory? If you do a deep
level, long term
memory. Very good. Finished? Alvina, tell me the definition.
Individual difference refers to distinctiveness and variations among people characteristics and behavioral patterns.
Yes, people's characteristics and behavior patterns. The distinctiveness and variations among people's, or you can write in people's, characteristics and behavior patterns. Basically, they are the differences in two things, the characteristics and behavior patterns. Okay, but we cannot write the word differences because we are defining individual differences. So we change that word into distinctiveness and variations. That is the definition, the distinctiveness and variations among people's characteristics and behavior patterns. That is meant by individual differences. What is the concept of individual difference? Which means people are unique in nature, people are different in nature, psychological attributes varies from person to person. If you take happiness, that is a psychological attribute, it changes from person to person. The level of happiness in you might be different from me. It might be different from some other person outside. Then intelligence, we all might have different IQ levels. By the way, what was the equation? IQ equal to
MA by CA into 100.
Krishma, what was the equation?
IQ equal to MA by CA into 100.
Aishwarya, did you think that it was wrong? Evident from your expression. Okay, IQ equals MA by CA into 100. In most of the board exams, this is a sure question. That is why I told you that as the first thing, even before we started learning anything about intelligence, I told you about this equation. Even before I started the class, I gave this equation, right? I told you to remember this. That is because of an effect in psychology known as primacy effect. When you are provided with a series of events or a series of stimuli, you tend to remember the first thing in the list. And that is known as primacy effect. And the last thing in the list, that is known as recency effect. Have I told you before? No. Okay, this is nothing related to this. Still, remember the equation. Okay, IQ equal to MA by CA into 100. MA and CA, we'll deal with this. We deal with in this chapter. But just learn that formula. Now, going back to situationism. What do you mean by situationism? Don't tell me the definition. Whatever you understood about situationism. What do you mean by situationism?
A situation in which a person is placed, which affects the person's behavior.
that affects a person's behavior. Okay. In whichever situation we are in, it influences our behavior. It affects, it has an effect on our behavior. That is situationism. Okay. So see the definition. States that situations and circumstances in which one is placed influence one's behavior. Okay, even if you don't get the exact definition, you have to write what the concept is. That is how you can score marks in the board exam. From yesterday, we are preparing for the board exam, not for simple normal classes. Okay, the fact that you pass in the school exam is not a big thing. Our aim is far there. Probably by next March, we have to be thorough with all these portions. So if we start now, it'll be easier then. Okay. Now, second thing that we discussed was assessment. See the definition? Assessment refers to the measurement of psychological attributes of individuals and their evaluation. Learn till that. Then you add this point, often using multiple methods in terms of certain standards of comparison. What do you do in assessment? You measure something, you evaluate that measurement. Okay, because we need a result, we need to understand, we need to interpret. When we did a test, that is PANAS and all, we did a test, we got a score, isn't it? In the discussion, we interpreted it. That is, we evaluated that result to know how much this person has gotten positive effect, how much this person has gotten negative effect. Okay, similarly, for any type of assessment, we have to measure something, then we have to evaluate that something. Okay, and we use the next sentences, often using multiple methods in terms of certain standards of comparison, which means we use different methods to assess all these psychological attributes. For example, observation, interview, case studies, psychological tests, and so and so and so. Okay, so another question to you. Do you think that testing and assessment, both are same? Testing and assessment, are both these things same? What do you think?
No.
No. Why?
Because assessment requires deeper knowledge of the thing we are assessing about.
And in testing?
Just the basic knowledge is enough.
Just the basic knowledge is enough. Okay. Those who say yes, that is, both assessment and testing are similar, raise your hand. Now, those who say assessment and testing both are different, raise your hand. like this. I want a straight one. Okay, so everybody agrees with Aishwarya. Now, any other point to argue that both are different?
In testing, we are not evaluating.
Mm-hmm. When we did a psychological test, didn't we evaluate?
No.
No. Without evaluating, how did we interpret the result? How did we discuss? How did we write the discussion? So some form of evaluation is there. Okay, any other point? Think, brainstorm. You can get clues from assessment also. Definition of assessment.
In testing, we get immediate or faster results.
And in assessment?
Assessment, we have to evaluate more and we have to study in depth to reach to a conclusion.
Okay. When we write answers in economics and all, usually when advantages and disadvantages are asked, no? Usually you write. How many of you are there? Economics students? All are there? Okay. Yeah, in 10th, of course, you have learned about it. Economics, right? Cost efficiency, time consuming, loss of that, increased profit. same points are there for most of the questions. Similarly, here also. So one is less time consuming, one is detailed, one is not detailed. Okay. And when somebody asks you what is the difference between testing and assessment, you can answer in a very simple way. Testing is a part of assessment. Understood? When I explained, I told you in assessment, we measure something, we evaluate something using different methods like psychological testing, like observation, like interview, and so on. So psychological testing is a part of the whole assessment. Okay, assessment we do as a whole. Suppose when a client comes to us for testing intelligence, what is the first thing that a psychologist will do? Which type of method will he or she use? Forgot. Laboratory.
Observation.
Are you telling laboratory? Yeah, observation. That's correct. First thing that we'll do is observe the person. The general appearance and behavior is observed by us. Okay. And then what happens? We do the rapport building, all those stuff, and then we do the usual test, psychological test. If he has come to measure the IQ, then we do the intelligence test. So the thing you have to understand is that psychological testing is a part of, it's a part of
assessment.
It's a part of assessment. Okay, it's a part of assessment. Psychological testing is a part of assessment. Now, next thing, we'll move on to the domains of psychological attributes. So these domains mentioned, that is intelligence, aptitude, interest, personality, and values. All these factors are some of the domains of different psychological attributes. Okay, we'll just read through them. Aishwarya, start. Psychological attributes are not?
Psychological attributes are not linear or unidimensional. They are complex and expressed in terms of
dimensions.
A line is a mere aggregate of many points. A point occupies no space, but think of a box. It occupies space. It can be described only in terms of its three dimensions, that is length, width, and height. Similar is the case with psychological attributes. They are usually multidimensional. If you want to have a complete assessment of a person, you will need to assess how he or she functions in various domains or areas such as cognitive, emotional, social, etc. We will discuss in this chapter some important attributes that are of interest to psychologists. These attributes are categorized on the basis of varieties of tests used in psychological literature.
First one is? Just read the first one. Which is the first one?
Intelligence.
Okay, wait. Now, did you understand what is mentioned there? Psychological attributes is like a box which has too many dimensions. Here you can write X, a line X, isn't it? But here there is X, Y, and third dimension. It's a 3D figure. So there might be many dimensions for one psychological attribute. Similarly, just the reason why I told her to read intelligence is that for intelligence also, you have different types and different dimensions. Suppose those who are good in music, they might have a high level of musical intelligence or the intelligence related to the rhythm. Okay. Now, if you are very good with the mechanics, that is repairing things, connecting, making connections, removing that, then making another connection, all those things, if you're very intelligent in, Then you have mechanical intelligence. So in the theories of intelligence, we learn about them. So I want you all to note that any psychological attribute you take has so many dimensions. It's not a one-dimensional or a unidirectional thing. Okay, even if you take happiness, there are different types of happiness. In positive psychology, we learn about happiness. We have different types of happiness. Okay, now we start with intelligence. Elvina, read intelligence. The first domain is intelligence.
Intelligence is the global capacity to understand the world, think rationally, and use available resources effectively when faced with challenges. Intelligence tests provide a global measure of a person's general cognitive competence, including the ability to profit from schooling. Generally, students having low intelligence are not likely to do so well in schools-related examinations, but their success in life is not associated only with their intelligence test scores.
Yes. So in school examinations, if a student gets low marks, that doesn't mean that he or she will not be successful in life. Okay. So this school-related intelligence or the academic intelligence is not the sole factor that will determine your success in life. Okay. Then, what is the definition of intelligence? See that. It is the global capacity. Global capacity means the whole capacity. The global capacity to understand the world. Understand. First factor is understand the world. Then think rationally. You have to think. Think rationally. And use available resources effectively. Use resources effectively when faced with challenges. When faced with challenges, think of yourself. You're sent to school by your parents to understand and learn different concepts. Yes, that is why you're doing your schooling from the lower classes itself. Okay, from LKG itself, based on your brain capacity, based on your age, you are given a certain amount of training to understand the concepts. Okay, by now you know what alphabets are, you know there are different languages, you know there are different subjects, you know different concepts in all of these subjects, isn't it? Yes, so you have understood so many things. Then you have developed a capacity to think about all those factors. That is why some of you ask me doubt. Even if you don't ask me, you might have some doubt, isn't it? At least. So you think. Critically, you think about different concepts in your surroundings. Might not be in your surroundings, but in different things happening in your life, you might think about it. Okay, think rationally, not irrationally, think rationally, which means think with reasons. Think in a very productive manner, not the illogical thinking. Okay, thinking rationally is involved in intelligence. Then with all this information that you have understood and which you have thought about, what will you do? You use those resources when a problem comes. Okay. I'll take an example of driving. You have appeared for a driving license test, okay? And the first thing that you have done is you have understood that. Understood what a car is, understood how the thing works, understood how to drive the car. And then finally, before the exam, you're thinking about it. Yes, if one vehicle comes this way, tomorrow I'm having a test. If one vehicle comes this way, I have to go this way. I have to put indicator. Then I have to do the acceleration, deceleration. Then I have to put the brake in particular situation. Then even if I feel nervous, I shouldn't show that because that wouldn't help me in getting my license. So you think, isn't it? You think rationally. You think with reasons. Then finally, when the day comes, what do? You use that resources. you use that resources when you are faced with some challenge. This is intelligence. Okay, if you just understand things, how to drive the car, what a car is, all those things, you don't think about it, you don't use it when you face the challenge. That is, when you appear for the test, you don't use it. Then can I call you intelligent? Can I call you intelligent? You know it, but you are not thinking about it. You are not using it in your life when you face challenges. Can I call you intelligent? No. So all these factors only can make up intelligence. That is why it is known as the global capacity. Read the definition once more. Global capacity to understand the world, to think rationally, and use the available resources effectively when faced with challenges. Did you understand? Now learn the definition now itself. It is the global capacity to understand, think, use. These are the key terms. Then you have to write what to understand, how to think, and what to use, and when to use. Okay, that is intelligence. Okay, now we'll finish this. Next one is aptitude. Grishma, read what aptitude is.
Aptitude refers to an individual's underlying potential for acquiring skills.
Yes, that is the potential for acquiring skills. Potential for acquiring skills means? Yes. Sana, you have the potential to acquire drawing skills. So you can become a very good artist. You are a very good artist. You can improve that. You can be very good in that particular field. Isn't it? That is because you have an aptitude in the artistry or in drawing. Okay. Some other person who has a very good aptitude in language skills, in attaining language skills, then that person tends to become a very good author or a very good writer. Another person, again, I told you about the mechanical intelligence. Yes, who can acquire mechanical skills very fast, that person tends to be a mechanical engineer. So the aptitude depends on the potential that you have in acquiring a particular skill. Okay, now next one is interest. Interest, you know, the preference. Which one do you want, coffee or tea? That is your preference. I prefer coffee to tea. So I have interest in drinking coffee. Similarly, the field in which you are interested, that is one domain. Then personality. Personality refers to relatively enduring characteristics of a person that make her or him distinct from others. That makes you unique, that makes you different from others. Enduring means long lasting. Okay, the fact that I just shouted at you today doesn't mean that I am a very aggressive person throughout my life. That's not my personality. I might be a very calm person, but suddenly because of situationism, I might shout at you on that particular day. But with that, you cannot judge me because that might not be my personality. Okay. Which means personality is very long lasting. That is the word enduring. Enduring means long lasting. The long lasting characteristics of the person that makes him or her different from the others. That is personality. The next one is values. Values are also long lasting beliefs about an ideal mode of behavior. I know you have learned about moral values, that values, this values, to be honest in life, to be loyal to someone you love, then to be punctual, then have discipline in your life. This is right, ethical values. You're familiar with the values, isn't it? So they are the long-lasting beliefs about an ideal behavior. Okay. So for the next class also, you have to study the portion till this, till values and come. Okay, put a mnemonic and learn all those factors or domains. Intelligence, aptitude, interest, personality, values. You can use the first letter technique or something and learn that and come. Okay? It's almost time. Yes, any doubt? As usual. Okay, thank you then. Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you.